I cannot explain what just happened now. It said I was live. It said I was streaming. I had no dropped frames. I got an email notification that the channel was live, but I was not live. So I just dropped it, tried it again. Happened a second time, so it's all good. Yes, I'm here. Thank you so much for being patient. I'm sorry. I was on time. I just, technology. Okay, so I've become a bit of a mod whore. I've got like 5 mods. I've never done this before in my life. I always stick with 1 mod at a time, and I've got 5 going. They're 4, but still. What happened? Oh, excellent. I have an announcement. Well, it's not an announcement. We're going to find out. All right. I don't want to get anybody's hopes up. Nah, we'll be good, Richard. Sees what life is like on the other side. I know. I don't know what happened to me. All right. So, I don't want to get anybody's hopes up. For those of you who live north of the border, and that would be in Canada. However, I do have this. I'm going to actually put this up. This is something, and Patches by Patches lives very close to the border, and he lives near a customs office. So he is going to go and talk to them about this. Okay, but I'm going to show you guys something that was recently released. All right. And I'm going to read it off to you. And if this says what I think it says, we may be able to bring nicotine into Canada now. All right. So we have customs notice 18-05, Ottawa, May 24th, 2018. This customs notice is to advise that the Tobacco and Vaping Products Act has received royal assent and came into force on May 23rd, 2018. Vaping products, formerly known as e-cigarettes and electronic nicotine delivery systems, including vaping devices and their individual parts such as atomizers and vaping liquids. Most vaping devices consist of a battery, a heating element, a tank or reservoir, and a mouthpiece worked by heating the vaping liquid to form an aerosol that is inhaled by the user. Nothing we don't know yet, right? Prior to the TVPA implementation, Health Canada considered any concentration of nicotine in a vaping product to be a prescription drug and commercial import. Alright, so commercial import was prohibited. Again, nothing we didn't know. We know we can't send nicotine to Canada. Personal shipments of vaping products containing less than 66 milligrams per milliliter. Okay, that would cover like Nick salts, but maybe not DIY. Only identifiable where the vaping product specifies the concentration. Over-the-counter or natural health product ingredients, including reusable delivery systems with or without health claims, may be imported for personal use. May be imported right here. May be imported for personal use. Reasonable amounts for 90-day supply within a 90-day period. Commercial shipments of vaping products with no health claims and no health product ingredients can contain nicotine as sole ingredient. May now be imported into Canada under the TVPA. Commercial shipments of unlicensed vaping products and any vaping products that make health claims regardless of ingredients contained are not admissible. So personal shipments containing less than 66 may be imported for personal use. And commercial shipments may be imported. I'm excited about this. So big announcement on the Canada front. Okay. Need to rate. Well, that's just it. He is going to go down to customs and he's going to bring this to them and he's going to see what they have to say. Now, does that mean I'm going to start shipping nicotine to Canada? Not yet. All right. Again, as Dolores pointed out, you can get 100 milligram right there. Well, right. You can get it from within the country, but you can't. It can't cross the country border. So the parcel you sent showed it's in Toronto.
Yay!
On its way to its destination.
Yay!
All right. So hi. How you doing there, Jeremy? What's up? So yes, finally we can. Well, not yet. I'm not jumping the gun yet. I'm still gonna get some clarification and explanation from a real Canadian at a real Canadian customs office before I do that. And I might even still wait a while before I do that. But there we go. We're very, very, very excited about that. Happen to open a Windsor Higgy shipping depot. You willing to run that for me there, Patches? Hi, Cassie. So, that is big news coming out of Canada. We're very, very, very excited about that. And what's that? Ooh, what's the 7th of July? What's going on? All right, the other big thing. The next huge thing, okay, this is all we've been working on. Well, not all we've been working on. I mean, we're still getting your juice out. But Peach has been donating her time. We have been staying. We have been driving all over the state. We've been staying late, trying to get this in order. And, trying to get this in order because next week, starting at 2 p.m., here, right here on VU Live, will be the 3rd annual GSFA auction. And oh my God, do we have so much stuff. Guys, I had to bring 2 bookcases into my office because we started numbering everything. Okay, everything's numbered now. So every little bundle package is numbered, right? To help us get through this a little bit quicker. And I have so much crap in my office right now. And it's not crap. It's amazing stuff. I have so much juice. I have so many mods. I have so many addies. I have so... Oh, my gosh. And more is still coming in. I am still expecting packages from... I put it in the post today. I didn't even put it. I'm still expecting packages from Lead Pipe, from Kia, or District 4, I should say. Just a tip. I'm still expecting a package from KMG. I'm still expecting packages from... The End Vapor Shop in Canada, by the way. I'm still expecting a package from Eva. I have got so much here. I could potentially, maybe... I mean, only one of the bookshelves is full, but I'm starting to work on the second bookshelf. We have almost 300 entries! That's just entries. Almost every single one of these is some sort of bundle package, guys. You guys are going to have so much stuff to bid on. I mean, there are high-end mods, low-end mods, mid-range mods, high-end addies, low-end addies. I mean, we've got old-school vintage stuff, new stuff, like not so new stuff, but good stuff. Like there's so much. I'm so overwhelmed right now. This is why I'm not in Chattanooga. Chattanooga is only 2 hours away. 3 hours away. Chattanooga's like 3 hours away, and Vapors Carnival is going on up there right now, and I've got like a bunch of people there right now that all want me to be there. I am so overwhelmed right now. It's amazing. You guys are going to have so much fun, and we are going to have so much fun. We're going to be exhausted, but we are going to have so much fun. We have designated the next 2 weekends, 8 hours a day, to this auction, and you guys are going to be amazing. I can't wait. I can't wait to see, for you to see all of this amazing stuff we have. Okay, you want a sneak peek? I could put the camera on my bookshelves right here across, on the other side of my monitors. Like I said, one bookshelf is slap full. The other one has just started, but I'm going to fill it up in no time. And I am still expecting so much to come in. Oh, Richard, there is, as of right now, okay, and I must have 6 boxes full of stuff in there. I have gotten stuff in Suck My Mod. Matt from Suck My Mod sent me a package. I've got Marshall from KMG sending me, like, mods galore. He is sending me the entire color line of Eclipses. One of every color. You know how much I love this mod, guys. He is sending me one of every single color.
We're getting them.
Okay, he is set. We have so much good shit. Yes, Dolores, thank you. I will put that in right now. I'm putting in a clickable link right now. If you have not already said that you're interested in going to this event, please do so on Facebook. That way you'll get a notification. Facebook will say, hey, your event's about to start. And then you can come here and you can hang out. I do not have a schedule. Okay. The list is partial. It is not complete yet. There is almost 300 entries at this point, but I have so much more that is not cataloged. We are not done cataloging Karen Norris's from Vapewares products yet. I also have boxes in there from Bad Modder Fogger. I've got a box from Matt from Suck My Mod. I have a box from Kinsey's Clouds here in Jefferson, Georgia. I have 3 bags full of stuff from Viral Vapes. I've got so much. There's so much. All right, here we go. I'll give you guys a little bit of a sneak peek. I don't want to make you guys like all, I don't want to get you all. All right, let's see if this works. Oh, it's upside down. Hang on. Wait, let me go back. Hang on, it's upside down. How do I go into preview editor? Here we go. Oh, you know what I could do? I could just turn the camera upside down. Never mind. Let's turn the camera upside down. Here we go. Alright. Now, this is... Oh, the shelves are smack full. Okay. They are so full of stuff. Okay, those there on the end there, those are some juice and t-shirt bundles. Okay, these are all in, but look, oh, what's that? Is that an SX Mini? Oh, yes, it is. That is an XS Mini, SX Mini. That is a G-Class, limited gold and black edition G-Class. Look at, oh, look at this. I can't even get it around. Look at all that. Okay, now we go up here. Oh, and there's, oh, you can't see it actually. There's another SX Mini, but it's a Q-Class up there, right there. Now, I haven't filled up those shelves yet, but I'm working on it. I'm telling you guys, there is so much. So much. Is it your birthday, Cassie? I haven't been on Facebook that much today. Is it your birthday? Did I miss your birthday? I have to see what I did here to my build campaign. All right, look at that. You can't. Look at my big belly. All right. There we go. Sort of. I still can't get this right. There we go. Okay. Whew. The milkman fridge. There's a wonderful story that goes with the milkman fridge. It is actually filled up with several bottles of milkman e-liquid. They're all in zero. That's all they had. They were getting rid of the line. But the milkman fridge, all right, the milkman fridge is a... It was something that milkman would give to a shop if they bought over $500 worth of product. And they had, they decided to stop carrying it, but they did have the milkman fridge. It's not a real fridge. It does have, you could probably take it apart and turn it into a real fridge. There's actually space in the back where you could probably install a motor and a condenser. I'll show you that on the when we do the auction. But oh, okay. I'm gonna have to be singing some happy birthday to some people here. Okay, so we got Cassie, we got Craig yesterday. Okay, all right. I love the eclipse, Dolores. The only problem I had with it, and honestly, I don't know that everybody would have this problem. I have very acidic skin. Any kind of jewelry that I wear, if it's not solid gold or like surgical steel, or not surgical steel, but stainless, not sterling silver. That's what I'm saying. Sterling silver or solid, and like a high quality gold too. It can't be like 10 karat gold. It's got to be like 14K or higher. I have very acidic skin. So I did have a little bit of a problem with some of the finish coming off the button right here in the center. But what I did was Bits and Pieces was so nice to send me a piece of red vinyl adhesive that she had. And I just put a piece of red vinyl on top of it. And it looks fantastic. So that was the only problem I've had with it so far. The finish has been fantastic. There's a couple of chips and nicks on the corners, but that's going to happen when you have a mod. I love the nice big screen on it. You can customize it. You can put your own pictures on it. And I'm pretty happy with the eclipse. I really, really like it. Okay, so I have to sing happy birthday. All right, let's turn off the music here. Let me get something to drink because it's for Cassie and Cassie and Craig. I don't have any .coms, Richard. All right, except for mine, of course. But I mean, no, I haven't been donated any .coms. All right. So Cassie and Craig, here we go. Happy birth. What the hell is wrong with my voice? Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Cassie and Craig. Happy birthday to you. There you go. Okay. So I have not even said hello to everybody yet. Okay, so we got tons of people in the room today. We got let's start in the beginning here. We got Jay Jerry, and we have Craig, and we have Richard and Gail, Sue, Aries, Vaping Smurf, Dolores, Joseph Taylor, the 12th Vapor, what's up? Patches by Patches. We got Tech Wiz. Pebs, what's up? I already said hi to Jeremy. The Saints, what you doing? Yardbird, what's up? You know what though, Craig, you could bid to shave my head, but you'd have to get a. Hello, Shelly. Who else is in here? I pay a lot of money for my hair to look like this. I'm not ready to shave it off. Just saying. Did I ever show you my necklace that I can't wear while you were here? I don't think you did. But yeah, I think you said you have the same acidic problem with your skin that I do. Other than the fact that and I don't even know if you could see it on camera or not. I'll try to show you. Like I said, I put vinyl over it. Okay, you see those little, get into focus. Okay, you see those little dents right there? That is where the vinyl is actually has gone down inside where the finish chipped off of the buttons. But like I said, Bits and Pieces was so awesome to give me some red vinyl that I could apply to it, and it looks fantastic. You can't even tell that I had to put something over it, and I love it, and it's nice and smooth. I thought you had a Q-Class Yardbird. You want another one? They make wigs. I have several wigs, actually. I like wigs. I have a bunch of them. I got some long ones. I got ones with red hair and ones with brown hair and short hair and long hair. I like wigs. I'm kind of a But I don't know if I'm ready to shave my head again. Or, well, I shaved it once already. I shaved it for the St. Baldrick's shave off a couple years ago. But I pay a lot of money for this look, this purple and blue, and I'm just not ready to shave it all off. You know what I'm saying? You thought this was a wig? No, this is not a wig. I promise. This is not a wig. I mean, I'm probably going to shave it off at some point because I've really fucked up my hair. Because you have to bleach the ever-loving fuck out of your hair to get it to the colors to stick like this. And I have bleached the ever-loving fuck out of my hair. And it's really damaged and like it's not even... When I did it the first time, I did it because I donated it. And because my hair, I had not colored it in years. And it was like super thick and healthy. The only problem was is there was a lot of gray. But other than that, it was super thick. It was super healthy. And I mean, I didn't have split ends or anything. And I donated like 18 inches, I think, to children with hair loss. And I mean, it was a nice thick ponytail too. I mean, it was like this. It was fantastic. But since then, I've decided to bleach the ever-loving shit out of my hair and dye my hair. Well, dye it somewhat. I haven't kept up with it too well, as you can see. Keep the colors. I mean, I'm enjoying the colors. I've been doing the colors now for what, like a year, and I'm enjoying it. Use coconut oil on my hair. I have thought about using coconut oil because I know coconut oil has so many benefits. I have not done it yet. I've used Pantene's 3-Minute Miracle, and I'm currently using this argan oil stuff. It's supposed to be sulfite free, so it helps keep your color, so it doesn't strip all your color out. And it's doing okay, but yeah. You do like the purple look? Thank you. I went with the purple because you guys used to say before the original lights that I had in this office, you guys used to say that my hair looked purple, even though it was really just the fluorescent lights bouncing off all my grays. And then whenever I colored it black, y'all were like, no, bring the purple. My hair, my natural hair color is black. Yeah, it's good. I don't know about 50K. I mean, I need to have some of that for myself, though. You know, I mean, I need to benefit something. I mean, if I'm going to shave my head, you know what I'm saying? I don't know if I could just donate all that to... David didn't have a problem with it, okay? David shaved his head last year because he does it all the time. His hair grows back really fast, all right? It's super thick, and it grows back super fast, all right? When y'all made him, I think it was the second year, y'all made him shave his eyebrows. They grew back in like 2 weeks. He was fine. Like, that's why he didn't care, because he shaves his head all the time. I mean, he gives himself a buzz cut all the time. I know it's for GSFA, but I don't know if I love GSFA that much. I do love GSFA. We do so much for them. Oh, good night, sweetheart. Mwah, I love you. Mwah. Thank you for hanging out, even for a few minutes. You know, Saints, I did shave my head for the St. Baldrick's thing a couple years ago. And it was the shortest my hair has ever been. I buzzed it down to about 1 inch long. And I liked it. I did like it. I didn't like the way it looked necessarily, but I really liked the way it felt, and I loved the care, you know? You don't have to do shit. I mean, like, you barely use any shampoo. You don't need conditioner. I mean, I did still use conditioner, but didn't need it. It dried quickly, you know? You didn't have to style it much. I was just like, man, I told some of my girlfriends, I said, we have been big fools with all this long hair bullshit. We have been big fools. It is so easy to have a crew cut. And yeah, no, I would do it again. I totally would. I'm just not ready to waste all this money that I spent on, because this is not cheap. This is why I only do it like every 4 months, because it's not cheap. And I let it grow out like 2-3 inches before I do it. David wouldn't mind wearing a purple shirt for a month, actually. He would have no problem with that. That wouldn't even be a punishment. He's got a couple of them. You shaved your head and it grew back on your back. I didn't have that problem. Oh, shit. All right. So, yes, next weekend, guys. Here, I need to put the link in the room. If you have not already gone and joined the event, please do so. Next weekend, starting here at 2 p.m. Eastern. 2 p.m. Eastern. Okay, so that's 7 p.m. for you UK folks. And I know it goes really super late. I know it goes until like 3 in the morning for you guys. And I'm sorry. But it's really just, it's the best times that we could try to get for the in-between for both of you guys, you know, both UK and all over the world for that matter. I mean, I know I have people that come in from Australia and New Zealand and Sweden and Belgium and all kinds of places. So my hair is real long and I won't cut it either. Plus mine is real thick. Well, I know, Joanne, like I said, the only reason... I did it because I could donate it. And Saints, I would have gone completely bald. There are a couple of people who did, a couple of ladies who were on that year that did go completely bald. The only reason I can't is I have three spots on my head that are like lumps. They're called sebaceous cysts, and they don't do anything. They're just a lump basically, but I have to go have them surgically removed, and they're kind of gross, so I wouldn't want to gross y'all out with my lumpy head. that's my only problem, is it would just gross you guys out to see these lumps. I got one in the back and I got one up here, and then I got something else right over here that, yeah, I just need to go have those surgically removed. Short hair it really is liberating, Dolores. I'm with you. I'm very, like I said, when I did it, I told my mom, I told my girlfriends, I told my sister-in-law. I was like, girl, we have been big fools. All right, these men are keeping a secret from us about how awesome it is to have short hair. I don't know if it's necessarily a pimple popper kind of situation. I think it needs to be. It needs to be scraped out. And yeah, they're just kind of gross. They don't hurt or anything. They just sit there and they're just gross. That's awesome, Richard Wills. I knew a guy who used to do that. He used to grow his hair out super long and then donate it, shave it off. You know, well, not in that order. He'd grow it out super long, shave it off, donate it. Grow it out super long, shave. I mean, he did it over and over and over and over again. And he was Latino, so he had that, like, silky black hair. That really nice stuff. Yeah. My hair was longer than yours at one point in my life. I enjoy my hair now. Pixie cuts for the win. Like I said, I'm feeling you. I know. I've been there. I like the way this looks better, though, so. I don't like watching pimple popping videos. They're gross to me, Aries. I don't know. Like, I know that there's some of you people out there that really get off on popping pimples. And I know that there's, like, for instance, I know David's ex-wife, she was all about it, too. And she was all, like, it would get mad at him if he had a pimple and didn't let her pop it because she liked doing it so much. I think you people are fucking weird. Oh, crap. I've got top chat on too. Thank you for the reminder. Y'all, if you're missing any messages, please turn on live chat so that you can get all of the messages instead of top chat, which only gives you some of the messages. So, lost too much hair during chemo. Now, Joanne, I was told, I had more than one person tell me who's been through chemo that yes, you will lose all your hair. You may not everybody does, but that you may lose all your hair or it will thin out. But when you're done with chemo, that it grows back like thicker and stronger and more beautiful, like that your nails grow back stronger, your hair grows back stronger. Like once you're done with the chemo, your body is sort of like cleansed and it's much healthier. Is that not true for you guys? Dolores, you're saying that too? It never came back? Oh. I guess that only happens to some people. I'm sorry. That would suck. I mean, that would be the only thing I'd be looking forward to it after chemo would be is that my hair would come back like all healthy and thick and shit. And my nails would come back like super thick and strong and shit. But no, if that doesn't happen to everybody, well, fuck. I have one big pimple sits on top of my shoulders. We should squeeze your head, Saints. No, Becca. No, 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 no. I ain't doing it. I ain't doing it. Y'all ever watch that girl, Heather Land? She's the I ain't doing it girl. She puts that filter on her face to make her face look like a troll. With a really big mouth and big eyes and tiny little nose. And she says, I ain't doing it. Even after 25 years, my hair and nails are shite. Oh, Dolores, I'm sorry. Well, I guess it doesn't work for everybody. Maybe they say that. No. Nobody told me that. Like, no professional. People who had been through chemo. I had, like, two different people who had actually had chemotherapy. And when they were done with it, and their hair started to grow back and their nails grew back, like that they were stronger and thicker and like really healthy. But I guess that may not work for everybody. I don't know. Oh, so it did work for Joanne, but not Dolores. I'm so sorry. That sucks. So there we go. We got a 50-50 chance that maybe it'll work. But the first and foremost thing is I hope none of you ever have to go through chemotherapy, and bravo to those of you who have, because I can't even imagine how awful. Ugh. All right. So yeah, exactly. Hashtag fuck cancer. So. What else happened this week? Okay, so, I'm going to tell you guys, fun story yesterday, actually, fun story. You went through, yes, I know Craig did too, actually. How did your hair grow back? Did your hair grow back thicker or no? And your nails, are your nails stronger and your hair stronger after you're done with the, or has it been long enough that your hair has grown back yet? Or, well, I know it's been pretty recent for you, Craig. Oh, that's so awesome, Joanne. I love to hear that. Joanne's been 5 years cancer-free. I know Dolores has been, what did she say, 25 years cancer-free. Craig, are you in full remission now? I would love to hear that. I'm not sure if I ever asked you that before. I went through a car wash once. The car fell apart after that. I would sue. Oh, I'd love to hear that. That's right. Hashtag fuck cancer. Full remission for 1.5 years. Yes! Look at all these awesome people in the room right now. Beating cancer. Brittle Narrow's hair has grown back except between my legs. So. Nice. 27 years. Awesome, Yardbird. That's so fantastic. Look at all these people in the room beating cancer's ass. Like just smacking them around and beating cancer's ass. That is awesome. So cool. I love it. Love it, love it, love it. That's so cool. All right. So yesterday was an interesting day for me. As you know, I spend most of my time here at Higgy Sigs, chained to the lab. I don't get to get out much. David is sort of the face of Higgy Sigs when he's the one who goes out, and he's the one who goes out and talks to people and visits shops, and he's always stopping in at shops that have dogs, and he sends me pictures of these precious dogs, and I just want to beat him senseless, because I'm like, if I knew that I was going to get to see dogs that much, I would be out every fucking day, all right? He doesn't get out there every day. He has a lot of stuff to do at home, usually. He works from home. But every time he goes out, I get pictures of dogs. And it kills me, because they're all beautiful, right? They're all gorgeous. They're all just have those big, huge puppy dog eyes. And they're all looking straight at the camera. And they're so fantastic, right? So David said, look, and I'm going to tell you the reasoning behind it too. Actually, he probably doesn't want me to tell you the reasoning behind it, but he said, look, he's like, we have two shops that we've been trying to get into locally, for quite some time. All right. One of them has just been very, very difficult. She brags about bringing in new lines all the time. She brags about having the biggest G selection in Georgia. She won't carry it, right? So now that we have our new retail exclusive, I'm a potty mouth? Okay. We should all start drinking every time fuck is said. Y'all be drunk in 10 minutes. When was apparently you have not watched me in a while, because this is normal. So now that we have our new retail exclusive, and I'm going to put the picture up to remind you guys what I'm talking about here. Our retail exclusive line. That one. Yeah, that one right there. How pretty is that, right? Now that we have this we should be able to get into these two stores. Now, both of these stores are run by women. And generally speaking, you know, David's a pretty big flirt, and you know, and he gets along with people, and people like him, which is, you know, why he's in charge of sales. But he just cannot seem to break into these two stores, and he says, you know what, I think that you need to go talk to these ladies. I think they'd rather deal with you. And I'm like going, I don't have any sales. I am not good at sales. Okay, this is why I was never a freelance graphic designer, because I'm not good at high pressure sales. I'm not good at convincing somebody that they need something, even if they say they can't afford it, or if they don't, you know, they don't want it or they don't need it. I'm not good at that. I don't know how to do that. And I'm, it's like the first bit of resistance I get, you know, of, oh, well, not right now. Okay, see you later. Bye. Like I don't know how to keep pushing to that yes, okay? It's just not, no, they're not. They're just new packaging. That's all it is. Pretty new packaging, okay? And it's just those five flavors, and it's a very limited run. Or not a limited run, but limited options, okay? You got five flavors, four nick levels. Single PGVG ratio, just straight up. All right. So here I am. Here's the thing though, okay? These two shops are run by women. So you need to go talk to them, because you both have vaginas. And I'm like, I don't see how that, I just don't, I didn't want to do it. I didn't want to do it. Use a hammer? Yeah. And so, yes, okay, here we go. We got, the red one on the end is Aries Ram. The green one is Hula Fruits. The blue one is Vanilla Nuts. Ha, blue scuba. Ha, ha. The pink one is Pegasus Tears. And the purple one is Peanut Butter Buster. So, anyway, I didn't want to do it. Well, I actually did not make it out to the one. I had a couple of other places I had to go. But I was the one on the road yesterday. I was the one that got in my car. I was kind of, I mean, I wasn't dressed up, but you know, I mean, I took some care into what I was wearing, you know, made sure I looked good. And I went to a bunch of places. Okay. Thank you very much. I appreciate that. I put a lot of effort into them. We'll make it a little bit bigger so you can see it. There you go. Can you see that? I know. We also have 60 mils of them here. I'm going to get you the 60 mil version. 60 mils are pretty sexy too, actually. Here's the 60 mils. No, go back up there. I want that to get bigger. There you go. There's the 60 mil versions. So you got Aries Ram, Hula Fruits, Nilla Nuts, and Pegasus Tears, and Peanut Butter Buster. All right. So, and if you need some real life versions of them, I've got here were my prototypes. All right. So, but David said, he goes, I will stay here at the lab. All I need you to do is to come in and make labels, because he doesn't know how to do that. So I need you to come in and make labels, and then you need to get out of here, and you need to go. He'd wanted me to go visit, well, the one shop is like an hour and a half away, and that was, and we, I didn't get out of here until about 2 o'clock, and I wasn't going to do that. But I went to, I made a delivery, because we had a big delivery to go to one shop. I missed, oh, what did I miss? Oh, Yardbird did it, okay.
Peanut Butter Buster is mine, bitch. QIM ice cream is mine.
I was looking for that Yardbird. Where, let's see, where did you say you got a new RDA? I must have missed that one. I don't see that message in here. Okay, so what RDA did you get? Or what RDA did you order? Because I'm not seeing it. I don't see your message. Because you guys know how I am feeling about my newest RDA, which is the Wake Littlefoot that I have now have, which I'm still, the jury's still out. We're deliberating. We're very, very close to a full verdict. But I think I have found Squonking Nirvana. Okay. I have the Geek Vape G-Box. And the Wake Littlefoot RDA that does come with a squonk pin, and I think I have found vaping Nirvana. You did? You ordered the Wake Littlefoot? Awesome! I love to hear that. Are you going to use it as a regular RDA or as a squonker? Because I got this. Oh, thank you, Aries. I got this because on the recommendation of Aries and Grannies. Grannies and I are huge .com fans. That's all we use is the .com. And Grannies was like, girl, this is the new .com. I love it. It's awesome. And the only thing, I'm going to give you the full verdict after I get my adapter, because I don't care for the strip tip. This is an 810 drip tip on here. And it does make the flavor a little airy. I prefer the vape to be a little more concentrated, and I think that once I get a 510 adapter on here, I will have found Squonking Nirvana. So, it's destined for your G-Box? Yes! So, I am so very, very excited about this setup. And yes, because you guys know, I mean, it's been like 2 years now. The first auction we had, I bought my first squonk setup. Well, That's not true. My first squonk setup, I bought a fountain, which was a little tank squonk kind of thing. It would just, you could put it on any battery, right? And I liked that one. That worked really well. I just didn't like the proprietary drip tip. Hi, IVC. Hi, Andy. What's up? And then on our first auction, I outbid everybody for the Steam Crave Aromamizer Squonk Box within the Squonk RDA. And that was okay, but it wasn't Squonk Nirvana. The battery life was super short on it, and the Aromamizer I found very airy. I wasn't into it. And then I got the K-Box from the Kanger K-Box, or Drip Box, what do they call it? Yeah, the Kanger Drip Box. The original one, still single battery mod, not variable voltage, meh. Then I got the Kanger Dripbox 160, which was great. Two battery mod, you know, nice big hole. Like, see here, this nice big hole for the squonk bottle, right? But it was tearing up my battery wraps, right? Damn it, you know. And so yeah, I have been on this mission now for 2 years to get into squonking Nirvana, and I may have found it with the G-Box and the Littlefoot. As soon as I get that 510 adapter, I think I may be there. Now, I know everybody has been talking about the, I'm talking about atomizers. Doc, you haven't been gone for a few months, have you? Has it been that long? I mean, I noticed you haven't been around, but I thought it was maybe only a few weeks. You know, you can't come by me because my days run together. But yeah, I know a lot of people are talking about the recurve. I have not gotten the recurve yet. I'm not sure if I will. I will be careful opening the package. Okay. I don't know what you got in there, but I'll be careful. I'm always pretty careful opening the package. So I am, I am super loving this. For you guys who don't know about the Littlefoot, it's got these giant post screws, which are pretty awesome. You can change them out for thumb screws because they're so big. But then the coils sit up nice and high like they do on the .com, and the squonk pin comes up in the middle. So when you squonk it, the juice sort of gets caught in between the coils. I don't know if you guys can see it. But it's like it's impossible to over squonk this thing, and that's what I really love about it. Because once I got the Gaia Cthulhu in last year's auction, thinking that that would be my squonk Nirvana, but no, it was not. It leaked, and it has that reservoir tank underneath it, and it just wasn't working for me at all. Oh, yeah, you did. Okay. I know. It'll be yeah, he did. I had to talk about it. Next week is the auction though. We're getting in some specialty coils from Aries for the auction. I don't have that many. I mean, I got the coils from Aries, and I do have some of those cheap Coil Master sets where you get like 50 coils, pre-made coils. In this, I have a couple of those. I have so much, guys. I have so much. Hi, Vambabus. I have so much stuff, though, and more is still coming in all the time. Like, it's so, I'm so overwhelmed, and I'm so feeling the love already, because what was the last track that was playing? Misery Business by Paramore. Is that right? Yeah, Misery Business by Paramore. Hi! Yes, box mods and drip tips from District 4 and just the tip. Thank you, Kia. Do you know if those went out yet? Because I haven't gotten them yet. I'm just saying. Do you know when they went out? It takes about 2-3 days to get here, so if you know when they went out, I'll know when to expect them. How you doing, Kia? I like the little restrictive airflow. And I like a lot of airflow, but I like it to get concentrated. And that's why I like the 510 drum tips. They should be there any day.
Yeah!
So we'll be adding even more to the list from District 4. I can't wait to see the drip tips you sent in. Hi, sniping snipers. What's up? So, I know. So we're so excited about the auction. I'm just amazed at how awesome, you know, every year I meet more people and every year I make new connections, and I'm just really, really excited to be able to reach out to all of these people all over the world, really, and have them participate in this. So it's really cool, and more people keep stepping up, and we keep making the auction bigger and bigger and bigger, and it's so cool! I'm a little overwhelmed, I'll be honest with you, Kia. I'm a little overwhelmed with this stuff. I was just telling them I have already cataloged almost 300 entries. I say me. I haven't done it. Kimber has done the majority of it. Peach Deck has done most of it. She's even donated her time off the clock to doing it, and she's been fantastic about it. That's her donation to the auction, is her time, which is awesome because her time is it's pretty valuable. Actually, we should all send some warm fuzzies Peach Tech's way because she got to a car accident. As you guys know, she's a Lyft driver, and when she's not working at Hickey Sigs, she lifts, except for on Sundays when she works at the post office. She got into a car. She's okay. The car is okay. It looked like it was just a minor fender bender, but she did go to the ER, and she does officially have whiplash. So, I would imagine she is resting right now and not sitting at a computer. Because if you are, shame on you. Go rest your neck. Everybody send some good vibes towards Marietta, Georgia, for her to get better soon, because we need her. And she needs her, and her kids need her, and people need her. So we need her back on her feet as soon as possible. I remember last year's auction very, very well. Jen got me two superb things for me, all for a great cause. Yes, yes. Andy got hold of me after the fact and said about those snapdragons. He said, do you have any more of the snapdragons? And I was like, I didn't, of course. I mean, those things flew out the door at $35 a pop. They were gone. So that's $180 RDA, guys, just so you know. And they went out the door. I had eight of them, and they went out the door for $35 a piece. So I contacted the distributor that I got them from, and he said, I think I can scare one up for you. So he scared one more up for me. And sent it to me, and I shipped it on over. Andy went ahead and donated the money for the shipping and everything for the RDA, and he was like, yeah, I'd love one of those. So I hope that you are enjoying it still. I told David I was going to get a bill to send him his his buddy scorpions if he don't keep the rage for you. I'm the one who likes the scorpions. Don't hurt me. Right, the rail box, that's right. We ended up being very late at night when we did the auction, or early in the morning over there for the UK. So, the rail box and the snapdragon. And I asked Justin if he had any more, and he did. He scared a couple more up, scraped a couple more of them up for me, and Andy paid the winning price for both items plus shipping. So, yes, that was really cool of him. Right. It started at 7 p.m. his time last year, too, but by the time we got to those items, it was 4 in the morning. Which means we must have gone over past 10 o'clock, at least one of the days. Okay, so the auction, the way the auction works is you will need to have an account at Higgy6.com, which I know you already do, Doc. If you don't have an account, you need to register an account, and we will have people standing by to approve accounts quickly. Okay. The most effective way, especially for people overseas, was for people to sort of keep a running tally of what they wanted or what they won, and only put in one donation through our website. Okay. We do have a special product on our website called Donate to the GSFA Auction. It's for $1. So if you won something for $45, you would put in quantity 45. And then there will be a small shipping fee attached to it. It's the lowest level shipping that we do, but we've got to charge for shipping. The first year we spent, it was like $600 or $700 just in shipping fees. And that took a big chunk off of the total amount that we collected. Last year we spent almost $1,000 in shipping, but because you guys were throwing in shipping fees here and there, we were able to get that down. You guys get it down to, we only had to take about $300 out for shipping fees this last year. So it worked really well last year, and we're going to keep it that way. But just so you don't have to pay shipping every time, it's better to keep a running tally of what you want and what you won, and so that you can just make one big payment, and then you'll have one shipping fee, and then I will go through after it's all said and done. I go through and I make sure everybody paid what they're supposed to pay, and if you didn't, I'll get in touch with you and we'll work it out. But when you're in the audience and you say, and I hold up something and I say, hey, look, it's the IPV Eclipse in red. And okay, somebody says, ooh, I'll take that for $20. And you say, I'll take it for $25. And everybody says, I'll take it for $30. And everybody says, I want $35. And then you jump in and say, oh, to pay $40. And everybody else says, oh, I don't know, I don't think I want it for more than $40. And they'll say, going once, going twice, sold to the original Doc for $40. And then you make a note of it, and then you would, if that's the only thing you want, then you're going to go onto our website. You're going to go to the GSFA auction item. You're going to put quantity 40, and then you would pay us $40 plus a small shipping fee. Any bidding you do goes in Richard's tab. Yes. Well, we didn't pay for it out of our pockets. We took it out of the money that we collected. Like I said, it was a total of almost $1,000 in shipping fees between everybody that got their stuff. But we collected a little over $600 in shipping fees, so we only had to take $300 out of the monies collected. So it worked out pretty well. I know, and the blue one too. Can you use PayPal? Maybe. I don't know. Our site doesn't accept PayPal, and that might get really, really confusing. I think that it's one of those things where if you can't go through our website, get in touch with me personally, because I don't want to make that like a public thing. I don't want people thinking they can use PayPal, because that would make things very confusing bookkeeping wise and all that stuff. I don't want to do it that way. Okay, it's better to keep everything on the books through our website. So if we have to do it, it just get in touch with me personally and we'll see what we can work out. Yes, it is a worldwide auction. Bambi Bus, there will be, the website is very secure and it is pretty simple to use. So, and we take all major credit cards, Visa, MasterCard, Discover, American Express. Yes, it will be worldwide. There will be some items that will be designated as USA only. Those items are basically the items that people are donating, but they're not sending to me. I have about four or five items. And I can pull up the list of those items because I have them marked. Let's see here. All right. From Clairol Clements, at Community Vapor. She's doing a complete line of Clouds of Goodness e-liquid. That's 8 bottles at 60 milliliters. She is only going to do, since she's keeping shipping those out, I'm going to send her the winner's information. She only wants to ship USA. Dimitri has talked to Inakin, and they have offered up a proton kit. Dimmy does not want credit for this. He said it's all from Inakin, but it is coming through him, and he will be the one shipping it out, and he only wants to do USA. We also have Vaping Watch is offering up 2 3 packs of 120 ml bottles, and they're USA only. And then we have The Breeze, who is designing a custom-made mod stand. And if you guys have never seen The Breeze's mod stands, you know they are absolutely phenomenal. I'm getting one. I already have a table set up. I already have ready to go for when it gets here. I can't wait for it to get here. I won one last couple weeks ago, and I'm so very excited. But she's designing a new one, and she's donating it to the auction. And that's a very big, bulky, fragile piece. So we absolutely are keeping that as USA only as well. But we will designate which items are USA only when we're doing the auction. Cool, Bamba Bus. I appreciate it. You're going to see if you can break last year's balance? That would be awesome! So... it's up to the individual vendor. Well, Vaping Smart, it's actually not up to the individual vendor, because we did have PayPal. That was one of the original payment options we had on our website. And PayPal tried to shut me down. if your vendor is using PayPal, more power to them. But basically, they're only going to be allowed to use it until PayPal catches them. Because once PayPal catches them using it, and if they are a vaping company, PayPal will say, nope, sorry, against our TRS. We're going to lock your account down now until you fix it. And they did that to me. So, yeah, no. I haven't tried sending outside the planet yet, Aries. What would that zip code be? I am not saying that you can't buy stuff via PayPal. I am just saying that those people have not yet been caught. Okay? They caught us quick. Our site was only up for maybe 6 months. Yeah. I would say about 6 months in 2014 before PayPal locked it down. So I am not saying you cannot get vaping gear through PayPal. Absolutely you can. I am saying that the people using PayPal have not been caught yet. Is that US thing? I don't think so. I don't think it's a US thing. I think it's a PayPal thing. That's a point, Smurf. UK PenPal might be a little bit more lenient than US PenPal. That's very possible, because they are a lot more lenient over there. that makes sense. Okay, bye, sweetheart. You'll be out of town again? Okay. All right. We'll see you soon. Love you. Bye. I can almost guarantee you, though, that your stuff is not going to go up until the second weekend. I guess we could probably shuffle some stuff around and make it happen, but yeah, because I already have 300 items for bid. Don't quote me, but I think most UK sites use Sage Pay rather than PayPal. I use Sage. Actually, it's not Sage anymore. It's they changed their name. They're called Paya or Paya. I don't know. How would you... P-A-Y-A. How do you pronounce that? Paya. Paya. Paya? Paya? Paya. You need a couple of new tanks? I got them, Richard. I got so much juice. I have some beautiful hand-crocheted market bags that Damn It Janet made for me. 5 of them. And they're beautiful. She sent the. Oh, they're so pretty, guys. They're so well made. I love them so much. You pronounce it Sage Pay? I pronounce it. I do call it. I use Sage. Sage Solutions is the well, just Sage really is the company. But yeah, when you guys go onto our website and you make a payment on our website, you're going through Sage. They changed their name recently to Paya or Paya. But no, I'm a big Sage fan actually. Sage got in touch with me. It was like right after I put up my website. And they were like, hey, we, you know, like that was the thing. Like you'd get in touch with these people and they'd be like, yeah, we'll do credit card processing. And then they find out you're into vaping, you know, that your products are vape related. And they're like, oh no, never mind. Sage got in touch with me and they're like, hey, we know you're vaping. We work with lots of vaping companies. We're cool with it. We understand it. We're fine with it. Let's make a deal. And I was like, hell yeah, let's make a deal. Remember where PayPal HQ is. Where is PayPal HQ? Probably California, I would imagine. Like I said, I don't know. I don't know if the UK PayPal would be more lenient, but I know that my PayPal account got locked until I removed it from my website. And then they tried to lock it again, telling me I still had it on my website. And I'm like, no, don't. I've actually reset the puff counter on this thing. I've taken over 1,000 puffs on this. All right. Now, tonight's recipe is a little crazy. It wasn't J. Jerry. Was it Daedalus or was it J. Jerry? Oh, this is okay. J. Jerry asked for this flavor. J. Jerry's here. It's a little crazy. It's a little crazy. And I'm not really sure exactly how I want to handle it. All right, but tonight's recipe is going to involve 6 flavors. I never did get the papaya in, sweetheart. I'm sorry. So no papaya tonight. So we're going to take the papaya out. Cheese and onion and bacon flavor? No, it is not. Ew, why would you want to bake that? Yes, we are making juice tonight. But it's a little complicated. J. Jerry asked for this a while back. Now, I mean, I'm not saying it won't be good. But it's going to be a little complicated. I'm not exactly sure how I want to handle it yet. I've been dreading it a little bit. I'll be honest with you. I'm a little nervous. So we're going to use, it's going to have cantaloupe, cotton candy, cucumber, dragon fruit, honeydew, and culotta. Why am I? I've been so excited. I'm talking too much. So, now. It sounds good to you, Casey? All right. So it's going to be very fruity. I think it's that cucumber tends to be a very bright, brisk flavor. It definitely adds some... you know, when I made that... You want to call it Tutti Frutti? We call it Tutti Frutti. I don't... Tutti Frutti seems more like a berry to me, though. There's no berries in here. Try again. We've got cantaloupe, cotton candy, cucumber... dragon fruit, honeydew, and culotta. So now, a couple weeks ago, I made the watermelon cucumber, and that was pretty dang tasty. I was very surprised at how interesting that was. So I'm open-minded. I'm nervous, but I'm open-minded. My shirt, look, I got look at this shirt. It's like all like splotchy and like artsy. Isn't that cool? Like I like it. It's all like paint splotches, but flowers at the same time. Yeah, there you go, Doc. There you go. The cool thingy. Cool thingy. Dragon fruit honeydew. Yeah, that's it. Cantaloupe, cotton candy, cucumber, dragon fruit, honeydew, and culotta. So add honeydew to that mix, Dolores. I hope I can too, Casey Lynn, because I tell you what. Man, this tea that I made. Oh! I love this so much. It does taste different to me in this RDA than it does in my .com. But I'm waiting on that drip tip, that 510 connector. I think it's going to taste more like what I'm used to in my .com once I get the 510 drip tip. Dragon fruit is very strong. You're very right. Well, the culotta is going to be the super heavy hitter. We just want to give it a little bit of coolness. We don't want to make this minty at all. Okay, so we're going to keep culotta super light, alright? Out of the rest of those flavors, between cantaloupe, cotton candy, and cotton candy is going to be a sweetener, okay? That's really what it's there for, is a sort of a fluffy sweetness, alright? Out of cantaloupe, cotton candy, cucumber, dragon fruit, and honeydew, I can tell you right now, and I just know this from experience, that cucumber and dragon fruit are going to be the strongest out of here, okay? Yes, I do have TFA's dragon fruit. No, it's not David's tea. I made an Earl Grey tea, actually, sniping. It's modeled after Twining's Lady Grey tea, which is a more citrusy version of Earl Grey, and it's my favorite tea, and oh, it's so good. Oh, it's so good. And it kills me. So, you need to try cucumber. We have a cucumber mint, you know. But yeah, cucumber and dragon fruit are going to definitely hit the hardest out of the rest of them. So we want to keep those two low. Do we want to keep them the same amount? Yeah, I think we want to keep the cucumber and the dragon fruit at the same level, right? So, yeah, that's we're going to work that with that. Yeah, Jerry, is there any particular flavor you want to be the hero? Because that will definitely make a difference in the way I build this recipe. He didn't give away from what I sent him for the auction. He did not drop off anything yet, Richard Wills. And I need to, like, whip him with a wet noodle or something, because he has not been around for weeks. And I don't know where the hell he is. All you really, Vampivus? So you totally know what it... I made a vape that tastes just like it. Like, just like Lady Grey with a little bit of sugar. And it's so good. And I cannot sell it to you, and I'm so sorry to tease you with it. I tell you what, Richard. How about you yell at him? Maybe if you yell at him and I yell at him, he'll get the message and drop his ass over here. Here I am teasing you with it on screen. The other thing I wanted to show you guys, and I think I showed you this last... Oh, I can't. It's over there, and my purse is over there. All right. I can't show it to you, but I have a squonk filler. It's a bottle. It's a silicone bottle. You fill up with juice, and you can use it to squeeze juice down into your squonk as a 510 connector at the top. So you just screw it onto your mod, and then you squeeze the juice into the squonk bottle. It's awesome. I love it. Okay, so you're thinking 4% honeydew and cantaloupe, 3% cucumber, 2% dragon fruit, 1% cotton candy, and 0.5% culotta. All right. So you think that the cucumber should be more than the dragon fruit, huh? All right, so let's see here. Let's see, what do I got here? All right, I'm working on something here, guys. I'm taking Aries' advice. Alright. The dragon prefer. Well, you know, it didn't last week. I actually am still using last week's flavor in my Eclipse. It's dragon fruit, peach, and watermelon, I believe. And the peach is still really strong in this. I think I should throw in 1% vanilla. You're killing me. You love the vanilla back notes? It would need more than 1% vanilla, though. You get a little cool shift between the melons and the cucumber with the vanilla. I would think it would need more than 1%, though. I don't think 1% is going to do it. Would the vanilla not throw off the cotton candy? The cotton candy is just designed to be a sweetener, really. The cotton candy is not going to do a whole lot except sort of blend them together. Not with the cotton candy? Wait. Not with the cotton candy? All right, let's see here. Alright, so we'll throw in some vanillin. But now I gotta figure this out. Let's see. Alright. You guys are making me work. It's not adding up to 15. Alright. No vanilla and won't taste good with dragon fruit. Oh, actually, no, vanilla would taste very good with dragon fruit, actually. J. Jerry has spoken, no vanilla? Alright, let's go back. Now I gotta figure this out again. Wait, what am I missing now? Okay. We'll be here when you get back. Oh, I love it with the fireflies. Possibly just use 0.5 sweetener instead of cotton candy and use vanillin. Nope, J. Jerry said Jerry said no vanillin. So actually this was Rocky IV Saints, but I understand the connection. That's awesome. I love it when the fireflies come out. Actually, I don't get to see them that often. You know, if you guys, it's been a minute and a half that you guys probably have seen LM Fisher. If you remember her from the old Vapors TV days, her and her husband came to Georgia. Her husband had a thing here in Atlanta, and so we went out for dinner, and we took them to the 57th Fighter Group, which is a really cool place right off of near. It's not really a private airport, but it's sort of like a, it's not a commercial airport either. I mean, it's more of a private, it's not like somebody's private airport, but the airport is very small and only like private jets, you know, land and take off from there. But it's Petrie de Cab Airport, and the restaurant is right outside the runway. And, so we were there, and we were, you know, so we're watching the planes and everything, and we're having this wonderful meal. And it was kind of early in the season, so there weren't that many of them out yet, but she saw a firefly, or as I call them, lightning bugs. I don't know, did you call them lightning bugs or fireflies? You know, the ones that light up when they're flying around. And she got very excited. She got all crazy excited, because apparently they do not have fireflies in Utah. And I did not think that was a regional thing. I didn't realize there were bugs that were regional. But yes, they do not have fireflies in Utah. It was the first firefly she'd ever seen in her entire life. And of course, they were all over. They weren't out in force like they are later in the summer, because it was kind of early. I think it was like in April. So they weren't fully out, like really out yet. But they were flying around, and she got all very excited. And it was kind of cool to be able to experience somebody seeing their first firefly. All right, so I got the 4% cantaloupe and honeydew. I got 3% cucumber. That's a lot of cucumber, man. All right, let's do it. Wait, what? It's been a long time that we've been apart. Much too long for a man who needs. And what did you say? 2% dragon fruit? Right, let's take that down. 1% cotton candy, got that. And 0.5%. Ooh, oh, I'm at. There we go. 0.5%. Okay. All right. So there we go. Aries has designed this one. I was a little intimidated by it, I'll admit. That could fit in right in with my Unu eating light diet. You're awesome. The only bugs we got in Utah are the ones that bite the shit out of you. The cucumber is going to be pretty strong in this. I'm a little nervous. That's a lot of cucumber. I'm not crazy about that idea. I would go for more 4.25% on the honeydew and the cantaloupe, and keep the cucumber down at 3%. But we'll see. We'll see. It's all good. It does seem like a lot. You know what? That's what I'm gonna do. We're gonna bump the cantaloupe and the honeydew up to 4.25%. And bump the cucumber down to 3%. I think that might. Yeah, let's try that. And then bump the cucumber back down to. There we go. Alright. Alright, so there's where we're going. So, our recipe. And let me pull it up here so I can take it over to the lab. Have we decided what we're going to call this yet? Tutti Frutti. Tutti Frutti is kind of cool, but Tutti Frutti is like, I don't know. Tutti Frutti seems to me more like a berry flavor, and there's no berries in this. So does anybody have an idea of what they want to call it? This must be sitting in the right? Yeah, Tutti Frutti is definitely got red and berry-ish, and this is not red at all. Afternoon Delight. You want to call it Afternoon Delight? I think I have an Afternoon Delight, but that's okay. We'll call it Afternoon Delight. Cucumber Cooler. Malumber Drag. Nice. Cool Cucumber. Jerry's Cool Cucumber. Heinz 57. That makes sense. Melon Camp. I like Melon Cooler. Melon Cooler. I like that. Melon Cooler. All right. Coolada. Nice. You guys are awesome. All right. So, Melon Cooler. All right. So we're going with 4.25%. Of TFA's cantaloupe, which is 1.3, 1% of Loran's cotton candy, 3% of TFA's cucumber, 0.9. Let's see, 2% of TFA's dragon fruit. 6. 4.25% of Loran's melon. I love that honeydew flavor. It's just melon. And 0.5% of TFA's culotta. That's such a small amount, too. All right. Well, we'll see. I mean, we'll see how it comes out. I really have no idea how it's going to come out. I was pleasantly surprised when the watermelon cucumber mix was delightful. Well, we'll get, you know what? I ain't scared. I'll do it. Oh no. Let's change my batteries before we go over there. I'm going to vape a little bit before I go to the lab. And I have got to remember to take my battery. I keep forgetting to take my batteries home, and I end up having to use my Sorin overnight. And I won't be here tomorrow, so we have, what are we doing tomorrow? We are going out with the twins. It's Father's Day, and we are going out with the twins for lunch. So we should be back in time for Trench's Funny Farm, but if we're going to be a little bit late, we'll let you guys know. Just make sure you... check the Vaping Underground Live Facebook group. We'll definitely post it in there if we're going to be late. I am so excited that we're getting one of every... I think there's like 7 colors. We're getting in 7 eclipses for the auction. One of every color. I am so excited. Hi, Lead Pipe. Hey, Tetley Man. Detrimental. Taking my son and his friends to a concert. Tech 9. Nice. Can be one of them flavors you may like in certain mixes. Hey, Jerry, I am open. I am not scared at all. All right. So you guys enjoy the music for a few minutes. I'm going to go into the lab and get suited up. And I will see you guys over there momentarily. Not crooked. I fixed the camera, damn it. Alrighty. So, you guys know the drill. You will need some supplies. You will need a bottle. I like the LDPE bottles because they are squishy. They also make PET bottles. Your Gorilla bottles that you guys are seeing everywhere now are made of PET plastic. It is a harder plastic. It is not a breathable plastic, actually. The LDP bottles actually do breathe slightly, not a lot, but slightly. So it is something you want to be aware of. It's one of the reasons, it's not the only reason, but it's one of the reasons why we shrink wrap the bottles, so that they are a little bit more encased and don't breathe as much while they're sitting. But PET is basically like glass. It does not breathe at all. However, if you squeeze on it too much, it can crease and crack, and it's a little bit more delicate than the LDPE stuff. I prefer the squishy bottles. That's kind of my thing. You will also need some gloves. Make sure you get nitrile gloves. They are chemical resistant. And the reason you want the gloves is because you're working with tobacco. I didn't say that. We're not working with tobacco. We're working with nicotine. The reason you want chemical resistant gloves is because we are working with nicotine. And nicotine is poisonous. All right. We are working with 100 milligram nicotine. And that can kill you. Okay. Enough of it can kill you. I promise. About a fifth of a teaspoon actually is enough to kill you. So please, please, please be careful with it. Make sure you're always wearing proper protection. Especially if you're working with 100 milligram or over. If you're working with more than 100 milligram, I would suggest using a face mask as well. 100 milligram doesn't put off a lot of fumes, but anything over 100 milligram, it starts to put off fumes. So you want to be careful that you're not inhaling the fumes because those are toxic as well. All right, so you will need a delivery system. Let's see here. We need that on my flavors. Cantaloupe. I got cucumber. I got cotton candy. Cantaloupe, cucumber, cotton candy, and culotta. Then we had to throw in dragon fruit. And honeydew, which is melon. Let's see. There it is. All right. Now, I obviously buy my bottles in bigger quantities than maybe the average DIYer would. So, how you choose to transfer these into your bottle is kind of on you. I like to use these press-in adapters. They don't really work for anything under 4 ounces, but these press-in adapters, you can get them at medidose.com, M-E-D-I-D-O-S-E.com. And let's get my recipe up here. Does culotta thicken up when cold? No, but it can crystallize. And if it crystallizes, just warm it up. It should be fine. All right. I can't see the whole recipe and chat at the same time, so I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to put the flavors in here so I can pull the chat back up forward. All right. So always shake your flavors. I'm going to put 1.3 milliliters of cantaloupe. I really like this cantaloupe flavor, guys. I mean, it smells just like a cantaloupe. It's still good. We're going to put 0.3 of cotton candy. Just a tiny, tiny bit. 0.3 of a milliliter. So just a teeny, tiny bit of cotton candy. TFA's cotton candy really is very, very sweet. It is straight Ethyl Maltol, but it's pretty tasty too. 0.9 of cucumber. Point 0.6 of dragon fruit. .3 of Loran's melon. And last but certainly not least, just 0.2. Now, I'm not even going to measure this out because I'm going to put in 6 drops. 3 drops equals 0.1, so I'm going to count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of culotta. No, culotta does not thicken, but it does crystallize, or can crystallize. It doesn't crystallize as easily as menthol, but it definitely can crystallize if it gets too cold. So don't put it in your fridge, because it'll take forever to thaw out. All right. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to put in... Ooh, I didn't pull up my spreadsheet. Let's minimize that. Fix my spreadsheet for what we're looking for. Okay, there we go. All right. So now I have the same system for my nicotine that I do for my flavors, in that I have it in a bottle. I have a press-in adapter with a syringe on top. That way that if I do spill it or drop it, I'm not going to drop that much of it because it can only come out that little tiny hole at the top. But I'm going to put in 0.9 of nicotine. I'm also going to put in 2.1. I don't need to shake PG. I don't know why I did that habit. 2.1 of PG. And then the rest of it, I'm just going to fill up with VG. But just in case you guys want to use a graduated cylinder to do this, this portion of our program is brought to you by Glad Press and Seal. Ah! But I'm going to grab my VG bottle and I'm just going to fill it up with VG at that point, because everything else I need is already in the bottle, so the rest of it's just VG. And I'm going to grab a nozzle and a cap and I'm going to put it on there. All right, so when you look up in the light, you're going to see that there's like ribbons of PG. That's going through all the VG now that it's sunk to the bottom. The VG has pushed all the PG and the flavors up to the top now. And the nicotine too, because the nicotine is PG based. But if you just give it a couple of shakes, you'll probably still see lots of ribbons. If you give it quite a few shakes, the ribbon should disappear. And that is when you know you have mixed it properly. Oh, still see a few ribbons. Damn, this is being stubborn. I need to see chat. Cassie is off drunk celebrating. I know, I'm so happy birthday, Cassie! Alright, now we go. All the ribbons are gone. So, let's go see. Patented Boobsteep, or wait, was it Boobsteep? Patent pending. So, we'll give it a few minutes in there, and then we're going to try it out after we do some doobie wicks. All right, I'll see you guys in a minute, and enjoy the music. Now Paul is a real estate novelist who never had time for a wife. And he's talking with David, who's still in the Navy, and probably will be for life. Saturday, and the manager gives me a smile, 'cause he knows that it's me they've been coming to see to forget about. I want to be drunk. I got some gin in the freezer. I don't know. Do you guys, you guys seem to have a lot of fun the night that I did drunk Jen casting. I don't know if you guys want me to do that again or not, but that was kind of a fun night. I think I'm a pretty fun drunk. I could be wrong. No, there's no carbs in liquor. So if you have liquor and say a diet something. Oh, no. I made sure I looked that up. There's no carbs in hard liquor, like whiskey, bourbon, gin, vodka. No carbs. So if you had, say, a gin and a diet tonic water, no carbs. If you had, say, a rum and a Diet Coke, no carbs. A happy drunk is okay once in a while. It's been a few months. I know the drunk Jen casting was kind of a fun night, I'll admit. Sniping... I'm a gin and tonic. I'm a tank and tonic girl. That's my thing. Tangerine and tonic. I'm there. I'm all the way there. I mean, you can't have beer and you can't have wine. I mean, like, you might be able to sneak in a glass of wine because I think there's like 5 carbs in a glass of wine. But you can't have beer and you can't have wine and you can't have like wine coolers or anything pre-mixed like that. But, and nothing with fruit juice in it. But if it's just like, you know, like say Seagram 7 and a Diet 7 Up, no carbs. apple juice does have carbs in it, Zippy. Unfortunately, apple juice does have carbs in it. That's the one thing I hated about being on keto, actually, was I missed my fruit juice. I needed the fruit juice. So yes, rum and Diet Coke, Seagram 7 and a Diet 7 Up, gin and diet tonic water, like Jack and Diet Coke, you know, those, no carbs. I'm sorry, Zippy, I hate to dash your hopes there, but unless you can find a carb-free apple juice, and I wouldn't want to know what's in that, actually, if you found a carb-free, because it would not be apple juice. I know Michelob Ultra is pretty low, too, but you'd have to drink a lot of them. All right, so we are going to rewick. Yeah, I've kept last week's juice on my Eclipse all week, actually. And I've gone through, where's the bottle? Almost half the bottle. Not bad. It's very peachy. The peach was still too strong in it. It was supposed to be a peach, dragon fruit, watermelon, and the peach was definitely too strong in it. But I didn't mind it because I like peach, so. Aries is leaving because, but they've been doing so good. They really have. This set's doing very well. So I'm gonna do you proud. I'm going to figure this out, and I'm going to do you proud. You wait and see. All right. Oh, did you guys know? I forgot to mention this last week. Did you know that we are now carrying the coily tool? This is not, you cannot get orange on my website. You can get blue and green on the website, but we are officially now carrying the coily tool. Do you guys know what the coily tool is? If you don't, I will be more than happy to explain it to you. Because if I'm not mistaken, we are the first U.S. retailer. You all do? Okay. You're the first U.S. We are the first U.S. retailer to carry them. Now this was made for me, 3D printed for me. You don't know what a coily tool is? Well, Zippy, let me explain it to you. If you are a dripper and you have to build your own coils, or if you buy maybe pre-made coils, this tool is fantastic. Here's how it works. We'll show you an example here. Let me get my snippers and my tools and whatnot that I need. I need those. I need these. I need these. Okay. Doilies for the coilies. That's cool. Alright. So you have your RDA, right? And when you're installing your coils in your RDA, you know how it's like, it's really kind of difficult when you put the coils in and you have to snip the legs off. You know, it's like, I'm not going to do it right now, but you know, when you have to like, you're trying to like get in there and snip them off and the other coil is in the way and you have to get up underneath and it's all kind of, okay, this solves that problem, particularly on 4-post RDAs. because you know, you install one coil on this side and it's in, you know, post 1 and 3, right? And then you install a coil on this side, which is in post 4 and 2, and you can't get to that number 2 leg up underneath there. It's impossible to get to. It's not impossible, but it really sucks. So the coily tool, all right, is a very simple idea. You see it's sort of stair-stepped here on the bottom. And it's got numbers, okay? These numbers are millimeter. Then you, and then you throw the tank across the room, see? You know what I'm talking about, all right? So when you're, before you install your coils, you're gonna take this and you're gonna use this to measure how, oh, looks like 4.5. Look at, oh, see, 4 doesn't fit. Okay, so 4.5. My posts are 4.5 millimeters wide. See, it fits right in there, okay? So I've 4.5, this is the one I want to use. So I'm going to take, say, a pre-made coil here. All right. And I'm going to stick it through these holes underneath, through the holes of the 4.5 millimeter holes, okay? And then I'm just gonna take my wire clippers and I'm gonna snip these off. Okay, because now I have made my leg length, because see, this is stair-stepped on the bottom. It is stair-stepped. Let me show you so you can see this better. It is stair-stepped to be the width of the measurement that you measured it here, okay? So you just clip off the legs and now your coil has exactly the right leg length to stick in your RDA. Boom, done, okay? I think it's an ingenious design and it is available in blue and green on higgy6.com. Right there, coily tool, coily. Coily, boom, okay? So there you go. You can have one. You can have one at higgy6.com. I'll put the link in the room. There you go. The link will pop up here in just a second. All right. They are fantastic and I love mine. I love it, love it, love it. Okay. So, first thing we're going to do is we're going to take the wicks. Off. You have to get one. I might have some a special order ones coming from Simon, just saying, because only the injection molded ones only come in blue and green, but Simon, he may or may not be sending me some different colored ones that he's making on his 3D printer for the auction. You'll be shopping. Cool. Just saved my nails and nerves. Okay. All right. Oh, that one's tight. Oh, tight. Okay. So burn off the excess juice. I love my glow-in-the-dark vape band. It's easy to find my mod. Nice. You don't care about color? I'm just saying that they might be coming in some cool colors. Just saying. Look, they're heating up so evenly and so beautifully with no hot spots and no cold spots because they're awesome, awesome Aries coils. Woot! Look at that. Yes. Aries, you don't even have to look away. They look beautiful. They're so beautiful. They're awesome. Because they're Aries coils and they're amazing. And I think Aries sent me a picture. Oh, Aries sent me a picture of Leia earlier. Oh my God. Oh, I have to show you this. She's so cute. Look at this sweet baby. Oh, it is never not a good time to send me a dog picture. Just letting you guys know, okay? I will always want to see your dog pictures. Look at that baby. Oh, she's so cute. She's all like, what, Dad? Get that camera out of my face. Oh, I love her so much. She's such a little pistol. Do it again, let me see. Sure. I don't even have any fear. Look at this. No cold spots. No hot spots.
Yeah.
Okay. Coily Facebook next Monday for checking new colors you can win. Single or dual. Oh, you're talking about recommendations. All right, so let's get the show on the road. All right, so this portion of our program is brought to you by Muji. Muji Cotton. Awesome, awesome, awesome stuff. I better knock on wood. I'm knocking on wood. Those coals have been doing fantastic. I'm keeping those coals in there forever because they're doing awesome and they're not messing up at all. I did something right, and I'm not ever going to change them out. No, I will change them out sooner or later. You have to send you a pic. Yes, you need to send me a pic of your Min Pin Chi. Absolutely, you do. All right. So, if you've ever used this cotton before, you know that there is a layer on the outside. You know what? I'm going to try something a little bit different. I'm going to try... We're going to try something a little bit different. I watched some, I think it was on the Coily page actually, where a guy said that only taking off one of the outer layers actually helps to wick it better. I don't know. I've never tried it that way. But if y'all want to try something new, because I will. Okay, so the idea is you take off one side. Okay, and you start doing the tuggy thing, all right? You go ahead and keep the other side on. And you start tugging it out, all right? You start stretching it out. The idea is that we're going to roll it this way so that the fluffy goodness on the outside here is will be on the outside of the wick, and that the this piece that was more tightly woven will be on the inside of the wick and will actually help it wick better. I don't know. I've never tried it that way, but let's see what happens, shall we? This is very, very thick. Like, this is very, very thick. Muji cotton is very thick, guys. It's way, way thicker than we're not going to be able to use anywhere near, like, any of this, because this is a lot of cotton. I'm trying to stretch it out so it's thinner, but it's really thick. Alright, so we got it stretched out here. I did not take this piece off this side, okay? So I want to make sure that I remember which side is which. Alright, this is the fluffy goodness side. This is the unpeeled side, okay? We are not going to need anywhere near this much cotton, though, so I'm going to cut a crap ton of it off. So I'm going to cut off, say, this much. Oh, it's thundering outside, guys. That's very thick. If I lose power, I apologize. I'm just warning you now that it's thundering and lightning out. Well, I haven't seen lightning, but I'm sure it's lightning outside because I hear thunder. I'm going to cut off like that much. All right. So now we have this piece of cotton. Remember, we're keeping the fluffy goodness on one side and the unpeeled piece on this side, okay? So let's break that in half. Alright, now we'll flip it because we want this unpeeled piece to be on the inside, okay? So we want it to sort of be like this, like a harder wick sort of in the middle. Alright. This is very thick, guys. I don't even think that much is going to fit. Let's do like that much. There we go. Alright. I feel good about that. Alright, so this was the fluffy goodness side. Let's flip it over. Well, I saw a video of somebody who said that it wicks better when you don't peel both sides. So I thought we'd just give it a try. Couldn't hurt. I'm all about experimentation. But it's very thick. You know, peeling that other side off actually helps thin the cotton out and it lets you get more rolls. This did not. It's very thick, and I'm a little concerned about getting all of this cotton into the coil. I don't know. Oh my goodness, that was a big one. It's thundering pretty bad outside, guys. All right. Now. Okay, that went in pretty smooth. That's cool. Too far. All right. Let me use this side. There we go. Yes, the cotton do be sniping. It is an experiment to see if maybe it wicks better. I don't really know how I'm going to be able to tell that it wicks better, but I'm willing to try. Okay, so. As Cassie mentioned before, hashtag this bitch can take it. The amount of cotton you cut off is going to be very dependent on what your RDA is. Okay, this is a .com, so it's got this really deep juice well. Hashtag this bitch can take it. All right, so you do want to fluff up the ends. All right, this is already fluffed. But the ends that you cut with your scissors are going to get very compressed. So you want to make sure you fluff them up. If you want to comb it out a little bit, I suppose you can. I mean, there's going to be sort of some stragglers, some straggle pieces that are obviously not very well attached. And if you want to comb it out, you can. I didn't do it for the longest time. I have done it for a while. I don't know if it really makes that much difference. So there you go. All right, nice and freshly wet. First time I heard the woman say, "Oh my God, that was a big one." That's what she said. All right, so we've been boob steeping this guy, and we're calling this melon cooler. Melon cooler. Let's write that down. Do I have a marker? I do. All right, melon cooler. Too much fluffing. Cut a strip of Muji 3 times the size of your ID, 3 millimeters, yeah, millimeter piece, sliver off both. Okay, that's cool. This is what I like to do. Okay, this is the only thing that I do that's kind of, you know, eccentric. So, all right. So let's see here. Let's take a taste of what this tastes like. Well, that has a bite to it. What did I taste? I definitely taste the cucumber. I taste the coolness of the culotta. Tasted the cantaloupe, I think. Let's do that again. Okay, again, I'm tasting the coolness of the culotta. Definitely, I think the cantaloupe and the honeydew are sort of joining forces and becoming the strong, I don't know, that from a taste test, is the cantaloupe and the honeydew are kind of like joining forces and becoming the hero of the flavor. All right. So I use my excess, I need the ring of death, excess cotton to clean out my RDA, because you know it's all filled up with a bunch of gunk that you've been vaping on. And then you drop it on the floor. All right. Too much playing around? Am I playing around too much? What? It's only 10 after 9. I gotta fill up 3 hours. All right. Are we ready? Have I ever told you guys about this song? This song is by the band Great White. You probably know Great White mostly from the tragedy of the club fire that happened due to their pyrotechnics that they did on stage and started a fire in a club in Maryland, I think it was. Was it Maryland or Rhode Island? Does anybody remember where that was? This is Great White. And like I said, most of you probably know them from the tragedy that happened in Great White. Ah, thank you, Cassie. I will bring that up. So, because I actually have some stuff to say about that as well. Rhode Island, thank you. It was Rhode Island. One of their band members actually died in that fire. My very first concert ever was This Is Rock Me. All right. Now, I've been a Great White fan for many years. I've discovered Great White when I was around 13. And to me, this was their flagship song, Rock Me, okay? This was the song that put them on the map. This was their big hit, all right? My very first concert was the Scorpions, and as a surprise guest that showed up, that it got onto the ticket like just a few days before the concert, Great White was going to open for the Scorpions. It was Dio Great White and the Scorpions. So it was a great concert. So I'm there with my boyfriend at the time. I was 17 years old, and Great White had just released their song. They have this album is on the album called Once Bitten, and then their next album was called Twice Shy, and they have a song on that album called Once Bitten, Twice Shy, which was pretty big. No, they didn't cover it. They wrote it, as far as I know. I mean, maybe they didn't write it, I'm not sure, but it was a very big hit, from the Twice Shy album. And, anyway, so they're singing all these songs, and they're singing a lot of songs. Did they copy it from someone? It doesn't surprise me. So, here it was, they're playing a lot of songs from the new album, from the Twice Shy album, and they didn't play a lot from the Once Bitten album, but, you know, whatever. And I looked at my boyfriend, and I said, well, I hope they play Rock Me. And he was like, oh, they will. They have to. I mean, it's Rock Me. It's Great White. It's like their song, right? They did not play Rock Me. They closed out their set with Once Bitten, Twice Shy and did not come back for an encore. I was so pissed. The Scorpions knew better. They come out. They play some of their new stuff. They play some of their old stuff. But what do they close with? Rock You Like a Hurricane. Because they're smart. You're going to close with your most popular song. Like, what's wrong with you people? You thought Once Bitten, Twice Shy. I didn't. Mowgli is saying that they stole it from somebody else, which doesn't surprise me. Everybody steals. I was like 14, I think. I was having a birthday party. And I'm like listening to, you know, my music because, you know, my parents just listen to all this old, just, you know, really dorky music that I would never listen to because I was too cool for that. And it was a Kim Wilde's You Keep Me Hanging On, top of the charts, right? And I had my stereo set up in the backyard, and I'm getting ready for my friends to show up. You know, I'm setting out food and stuff, and I'm blaring Kim Wilde's You Keep Me Hanging On. You Keep Me Hanging on the radio, or on the record, whatever, record player, tape player, whatever it was. And my mom comes out, she starts laughing at me. And I'm like, why are you laughing? She's like, you know this is a remake, right? And I'm like, no, it's not. This is a cool song. You don't listen to cool music. I like this song. She's like, the Supremes did it. And I'm like, no, they didn't. And she brought me back into the house. She pulled out her albums, her big, you know, 12-inch albums, right? Pulled out her greatest hits of the Supremes and slapped it on and let me listen to the original You Keep Me Hanging On by the Supremes. Shattered my whole image of music at that point. Like, I thought, no way, my mom would not be listening to anything this cool. Yes, you did. And Kim Wilde ripped him off. I was totally surprised. I couldn't believe it. It was like my world was just shattered. I'm like, I could not believe Kim Wilde, this cool ass girl of Kim Wilde, was singing a Supreme song. I went to see them as a B-Day gift to X number 2, and they sounded awful. Aw, that sucks. I'm sorry to hear that. Vanilla Fudge did that too. All right, I gotta try this now. All right, so here we go. Melancholia. You guys know how to get me with these fruits. Mmm. Oh, wow. All right. Let me figure this out. I think we did it. I mean, Jerry, I don't know if you were wanting any one flavor to stand out, but I think we did it. It's got that teeny, teeny, tiny bit of coolness that you could taste on your tongue, like after the fact. So the culotta is perfect. It is doing exactly what it needs. Just that little bit of coolness in your throat. I'm not even sure I'm tasting the cucumber. I'm not sure what I'm tasting. It's very sweet. I would even almost suggest to leave the cotton candy off. The other fruits are very sweet. Dragon fruit is sweet. Honeydew is sweet. Cantaloupe is sweet. I'm not even sure you need the cotton candy. Yeah, I taste the cucumber in there. It's very light, though. I'm not sure that any particular fruit is coming out on top, though. If anything, like I was saying with the taste test, it's a combination of the cantaloupe and honeydew. They're coming together very well. But the dragon fruit is just sort of changing the whole idea of it being cantaloupe and honeydew. And the cucumber is just, I don't know what I'm tasting. That is really cool. I don't know what I'm tasting. I really don't. It might. Good night, Zippies. Thank you for hanging out. Make sure you create an account on HiggySigs.com and I'll approve it. And then you can get your very own coily tool. But yeah, no, it... That's a really cool flavor. Jerry, bravo. Like that, that's really interesting. And then you don't even taste the culotta until after you've exhaled. Like after you've exhaled, you get this little bit of coolness back here on your tongue and on the back of your throat. And yeah. Yeah. Like, I see your message, Jared, and yeah, I'm cool with that. Like, oh, that's so cool. I really don't taste, like, and now I'm kind of tasting some more cucumber and maybe some more dragon fruit coming forward. But they're all competing for first place. They're blending together. Like, they're totally doing exactly what I wanted them to do. There's no particular flavor that stands out over the others. That's awesome. And I love that little bit of cool hit you get at the end. This is so neat. That is so cool. I really like this one. Oh yeah, we saving this one. We saving this one. I'm sure, Aries. Yeah, I gotta drink some more. But that is really cool. I mean, I really can't. That. Bravo. Love it. And I thought these flavors would be just too wacky to put together. I can still feel, and it's like so weird. I cannot taste the cool when I vape it, but I feel it in my throat afterward. Like, I can still feel it right now. Higgy cannot sell this in the USA. We could potentially sell it outside the USA at some point. And honestly, I know we keep promising this, that we just have not had time. We are so busy between David and the GSFA and here at the lab, and I don't have enough help. But yeah, everything that we had on the market as of August 8th, 2016 is what we're allowed to sell. I cannot sell anything new without having prior approval from the FDA, and that takes, like, many years and millions of dollars. So, but, well, Casey, you could totally DIY. All you have to do is follow a recipe, right? This is, I mean, and this is definitely a flavor I would consider releasing. The only thing I'm concerned about, like, I know the culotta is there, and I know that that's what's causing this feeling in my throat. I would almost be concerned about marketing this flavor, though, because, like, at the moment, I almost feel like a sore throat's coming on. I know it's not. I know it's just the culotta that's causing that, and I know it'll go away. But I would be afraid that people would vape this and think, oh my god, it's making me sick. But it's... Now, you know, Casey, I understand that. I do. When we started out, we actually used to buy... doing, like, Sigalikes and really high nic, like 24 milligram. So... when we first started out, we actually would buy nicotine, like we would buy nicotine solution that was already like first of all, way back in the day, when you used Sigalikes and Ego Pens, you used very high ohm atomizers, like 1.8 or 2.4 even. And then you would use e-liquid that was usually 24 milligrams, and it was usually an 80-20 mix. When I say 80-20, I mean 80 PG, 20 VG. People didn't really do the whole high VG thing back then. So we would actually buy from My Freedom Smoke. So we would buy nicotine that was already 24 milligrams and already a 20-80 or an 80-20 blend, all right? So we literally were just adding flavor to it. That's all we were doing. And 24 milligram is not really that potent. I mean, obviously you don't want to pour it on you and you don't want to drink it, but 24 milligram is very, very mild. And like I said, we were literally just pouring it out of a bottle we're putting our flavors in a bottle and then pouring the stuff on top of it. That's literally how we started. We weren't even doing PG and VG mixing at the time. We just bought it pre-mixed, just unflavored nicotine. And I mean, that's something to think about. You can buy unflavored stuff from us. We have, you could buy like 3 milligram, 2575 or 3070 or whatever it is that you like. You can buy that unflavored base from us and then just add flavoring to it if you want to. We totally will do that for you as well. There's a product on our page called Higgy's Base. And if that's something you're interested in, you could certainly try that as well. Really? I don't even sell that much of it either. And I feel like that's a really untapped market, you know? Is that people could, you know, buy their own flavorings and then just buy the pre-made mix. I mean, it kind of surprises me that I don't sell more of it. I mean, I do sell it, but it's just kind of like a bottle here and there. Now you need money. Oh, maybe my throat is just getting used to it, but the culotta seems to be cooling down a little bit now. Not cooling down, but chilling out. It's not sitting in my throat the way it was before. This is such a cool flavor. I'm so impressed. That's so cool. Dolores, if that Canada thing is true and it goes through, and I mean, and customs knows about it, I think that's awesome. Because, you know, I have customers, you know, it surprises me actually how many customers I have in Canada that do order from me. You're one of them. Talion is another one of them. Patches is another one. You know, I mean, I do have customers in Canada that do order from me on a fairly regular basis. But it really does surprise me, because I mean, I think that that's a giant pain in the ass to have to add your own nicotine. I hate being able to only send zero nic to you guys. So if this comes through, then yay! We'll be able to send nicotine to Canada! Aries, make sure you're well informed. You can get a whole liter of unflavored base and then DIY your little heart out. There you go. And as far as flavors go, I mean, you know, it's definitely a market we want to tap into, where we start selling flavors, you know, just rebottling the flavors. You know, because we obviously buy them by the gallon. So, you know, we could totally rebottle them into smaller bottles. It's really just something we have just not had the time to develop, you know, to really put the products in place and develop a pricing system and all that for it. But I know there are lots of places that you can order flavors from, and you can order packs of flavors too. Even Amazon. I mean, that was my first flavor purchase was from Amazon. It was a 24-pack of little tiny 1-dram bottles of Lorraine's flavoring. And, I mean, you know, you don't use a lot of it. So, you know, when you have 24 different flavors, it may not last you. It's not going to last you forever, of course. But just to start out and just to kind of start playing around, yeah, it's fun. Oh, did Sue send a puppy pic? Where is it? Oh, let's see. Oh. Wait, where did you send it, Sue? Did you send it on Facebook? Because I'm not seeing it. Do you do your flavors and concentrates? Not yet, Vaping Smurf. We will. That's the thing, is that we it's something that we definitely have planned. We just have not had time to do it. Because that's the cool thing. We not only could rebottle other flavors, you know, plain flavors, but we could bottle Higgy Signatures, you know? And, like, say for all of those, all of these items, like, you know, say tonight's flavor or say the Earl Grey tea that I love so much or, I don't know, Kimber's Apple Scotch Pie. Like, you could just buy a bottle of the concentrate. How awesome would that be? Yay. And menthol. Yes. Menthol. Yeah. Because we actually make our own menthol here. Or something else. Yes. My regular page. Did you send it to... Where did you send it to? Oh, you posted it on my timeline. Okay, here we go. Look at the puppy pictures! Oh my god! Alright, we have to share puppy pictures. Look at these eyes and look at these ears! Oh my gosh! Look, this is Sukul's puppy dog. Look at how sweet. I just want to smush the face. It's so cute. Just smush face. I love him so much. Never not a good time to send me dog pics. Never, ever. I will always want to see your dog pics. Always. Aww. Paco. Too sweet. I love them. Okay, so Melon Cooler was a huge success. That's so awesome. Next week is a Cassie flavor. Oh, nope, not next week. Next week. You have 3 weeks to get these flavors in place, guys. Okay? I've never seen a diamond in so, it is pineapple. Pomegranate and saltwater taffy. Pineapple. So this is going to be Loran heavy. We're going to use Loran's pineapple. We're going to use TFA's pomegranate deluxe. And we're going to use Loran's saltwater taffy. Okay. Loran's makes a fantastic saltwater taffy. Loran's pineapple, TFA's pomegranate, and Loran's saltwater taffy. All right. It's going to have a bit of a bite. Might need some sucralose. Might need some sucralose on that one. I don't know. Pineapple is so sweet, though. Yeah, we'll throw some sweetener on there, too. You know what, Dolores? Miha, it's her ears, actually. Her ears are turning gray. I mean, she's got black on her face. And, I mean, she's black and white, so it's kind of hard to tell. You know, because the black and the white kind of mix together. But her ears have really gotten gray. It's so cute. All right, so we've got Loran's pineapple, Loran's saltwater taffy, TFA's pomegranate deluxe, and TFA's sweetener. All right, so there we go. That's for July 7th. So you got some time to get these flavors in if you don't have them already. All right, so the last thing that we like to do, oh, what is this? Later. is coupon codes. Coupons, 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 coupons. Okay. Let me make a note of that. All right, I got a note. Let me live that fantasy. Thank you very much for the warning. Okay. Yeah. The hair on my head is matching me hot pretty well too there. You see that? No, it's a highlight, really. It's just a highlight from my new lights, my new LED lights. Oh, Mowgli sent me a... Oh, I have to go look and see. Did you send me... Oh, Mowgli sent me a doggy photo. I have to go see. We have to go see doggy photos. Is he jumping? I can't see his face. Here we go, guys. It's a kind of a dark picture, but it looks like he's jumping from one stone to the next. What a beautiful dog. Is he part pit, it looks like, maybe? Look at that. Oh, look at him jumping. Oh, that's so sweet. My dogs are not that active. He looks maybe part greyhound, maybe? I can't see his face that well. Uh-oh. Did you send me something to laugh at? Oh! Oh! Oh my gosh, okay. Oh! She's like, wait till you see this look on this dog's face. She's like, I'm beautiful. I know it. Hell yeah. She's all like, hell yeah, I'm beautiful. What you gonna do about it? She's, you know what? She's doing the bend and snap. She did the bend and snap. That is so great. Did you see the Facebook video post of a dog climbing a tree? No, I did not. I missed that one. Oh, Mowgli, that's awesome. Street Mutt rescues are the best. She did the bend and snap. You bend and then you snap. And for those of you who don't know what that is, you need to go watch Legally Blonde. Okay, it's the bend and snap. All right, so let's pick a winner, shall we? Okay, thank you, Yardbird. Is Nightbot not working? Cassie H! Congratulations! Would you like a coupon code? Yes, happy birthday, Cassie. You just got a coupon code. You want it? Oh, okay. So would you like to piff to somebody or do I need to re-roll? How about... I know I've seen you around Mowgli Vapes, but have you ever had Higgy Six? Let's give it to Higgy. Let's give it to Mowgli. Mowgli, would you like a coupon code from Higgy6.com? You DIY? You still might like our stuff. Just saying. But that's cool. Oh, Aries, do you need a code? Piff to a newbie. Do we have any newbies in the room? I didn't see any other names that were unfamiliar to me. How about just somebody who hasn't had Higgies in a while? How about if you speak up and say you haven't had Higgies in a while, you can totally have a coupon code. That's cool. I appreciate it, Mowgli. Anybody? Yeah, who needs a code? Who's low on juice? Might need some discount. Richard Wills, you need it? You need a coupon code? You can have a coupon code. Which one do you want? You want 65% off or $1 sampler pack? Absolutely, Richard. 65? You want 65% off? Cool. All right, Richard, I'm going to put a link in the room. It is a Google form. Please fill it out. Your coupon code will be emailed to you. Congratulations. Oh, Detra won a code last night. Woot, woot. Yes, you should. I definitely need to make that clear. You cannot use any coupon codes on auction items, and auction items, the VIP discount does not apply to auction items either. Okay, no VIP discount. I mean, it's for charity, guys. Okay, I mean, the whole point of the auction is to try to get you guys a good deal on some stuff. We have so much juice. It's to, you know, so you get a good deal on stuff, but you know, the money is going to charity. So yes, you can't use Higgy Bucks either. We will actually probably be disabling Higgy Bucks for the weekend. So if you are placing an order, just a regular order, you don't, or and you want to use Higgy Bucks, don't. Just for the weekend. The weekends that we're doing the auction, we'll re-enable Higgy Bucks on Monday, but we'll disable the Higgy Bucks. No Higgy Bucks, no VIP discounts, no coupon codes. Yeah. All right. So let's pick another winner, shall we? Let's see if we can give at least one more coupon code away. Dolores! Hi, honey! You want a coupon code? You're broke right now. That's cool. I understand. Whew! Okay. Let's try again. Too cool! See, you sent me the sweet puppy pictures, and you get a coupon code. See how that works? You have one to use. All right, we don't need to give away another coupon code. That's cool. I'm re-dripping because I'm getting dry, and it's not good to take a dry hit when you've got some culotta going on, because that's just like double the hit on your throat. It does say welcome to Higgy Jail. We still haven't fixed that yet. Well, I'm certainly not, it's certainly not any worse. I don't really know if it's any better. I'm not really sure what to look for as far as it being better or not. I'm not sure yet. I'll have to get back to you on that. It seems pretty okay. I think it would matter more maybe towards like when the wicks are a little bit older. Because, you know, when the wicks are fresh, you could pretty much vape them almost dry. You know, the wicks stay pretty clean. And once you use them over and over and over again, that's kind of when they start getting a little gunky. So maybe. Obviously not that good if it's already dry. Really? You don't think so? I was vaping on it a lot. Okay. Alrighty, guys. Well, I tell you what. I'm gonna wrap things up here tonight. I really appreciate you guys hanging out. And I know, right? I mean, if you vape it a lot, it's gonna go dry. Plus the culotta in it. I mean, I guess I'm a little bit maybe more nervous about it getting dry, but the wicks look pretty dry. Anyway, I want to thank you. Oh, Cassie did bring up the code black. Next, you want to do it next? You want me to bump it in front of everybody else's? That doesn't seem right. You want me to bump it in front of Cassie's? I don't know. I think that maybe Cassie might have a problem with that. I do want to bring this up. Okay, good night, Dolores. Thank you for hanging out. While you guys are still here, though, that the commenting period has been extended. The FDA, let me get that link. I have to find it. There is it. It's the ANPRM, which is the Advanced Notice of Proposed Rulemaking. All right, they're going to regulate flavors. All right, now how they regulate it, though, is going to be supposedly... is up to us. All right. They want to hear our opinions on it. All right. So they have asked people to comment on it. Now, you guys might get a little upset when you go there. I got to find the link. It's right in here somewhere. Okay. When you go there and you're going to see, where's the link? There it is. Okay. All right. So you'll see. Okay. This says, oh, wait, it's been extended. Oh, it's a different link. It says this document period ends in 3 days. There's a different link for the extended one. And I don't know where that is. All right. I want to tell you guys a story, though. All right. Here. Does anybody have the link for the extended one? Our comments worldwide. You can put a comment in. I don't know if they're going to take your comment into consideration if you don't live in the United States. But this is the current one, the current register. You'll see that there's 15,000 comments on it. That is not accurate. Okay. There's an extended period. They have extended it for 30 days. This one says that it ends in 3 days on June 19th, but they have extended it to June 19th. I think there's a new link for that, and I don't have that link handy at the moment, but I'm sure you can find it in vaping groups or something. But here's the thing. You see 15,000 comments on it, and the thing is they are extremely backed up. I can't remember where it is now, but there's a link that actually says that they've received over 200,000. They have to approve these things like manually by hand, okay? And they're very slow to do it. When I called, I submitted my comment around 2,000 comments, and 3 weeks later I called and I said, why isn't my comment up? I see thousands of comments have been posted. It's up to like 5,000 comments now. Why hasn't my comment been put up yet? And they said, Yeah, we have 5,000 comments posted, but we have a backlog of over 7,000 comments. And that was like, when was that? That was the beginning of May. My comment has since been posted. When your comment gets posted, you'll see something on it that says comments not accepted. That does not mean that your comment has not been accepted. That means that no one is allowed to comment on your comment. Okay, don't get confused about that. But they have received over 200,000 comments. Keep them coming, guys. Seriously. If you haven't done it already, do it. All right? Overwhelm them. Let them know, okay, that flavors are important to you. All right? Hi, Foggy Ohms. How's it going? But it's very, very important because the way that this is supposed to work is that they're going to take all of these comments into consideration before they decide what rule they're going to make. Right? And if they realize how important flavors are, then maybe they'll make, you know, sensible legislation about it. All right? Because we don't want to get stuck with tobacco and menthol. There's a link from CASA.org. Thank you, Mowgli. If you go to CASA.org, and I can put that into the room. CASA.org. There's a link on their homepage to it. Okay, cool. All right, so there's my bit of advocacy for the night. Don't forget to come back next week. Next week, starting at 2 p.m. All right, if you have not already joined the event on Facebook, please do that. I'll put that link in the room as well. Then you'll get a notification letting you know when the event is starting. And you'll have an easy way to get back to it as well, because it'll be in your events list. All right, say go to that event, say you're interested in going, and you'll be on the guest list, so to speak. But it's right here at Vaping Underground Live. It's going to be the next two weekends, full weekends, 2 to 10 p.m. Eastern Time. We have so much. We have so much to auction off, okay? Save your pocketbooks, okay? Save your pennies, save your pocketbooks. Because you're going to need it, okay? There is so much here, and you can get some amazing deals, all right? When we have multiples of the same item, basically, we just let, you know, if I have four items of the exact same thing, I say, hey, first four people to put out a price. And then, you know, four people put out 10 bucks, and then somebody else will say 15. Okay, the next three people that say 15. And then somebody says 20. Okay, the next three people that say 20. And when it stops, once it gets to the point that four people agree on the same price, that's what you get it for. It could be a $100 item. You may get it for 20 bucks. It doesn't matter. It's all going to GSFA. And we have so much. It's going to be amazing. Your pennies don't even squeak. And yes, Richard Wells, we have gotten in some mech mods. Okay, we've gotten in some amazing mech mods. We got in a Praxis. Praxis V1. We got in a bunch of mech mods, actually, and I think there's still more on the way. So we got everything that's right up your alley. We got juice, we got drip tips, we got mods, addies, RDAs, RTAs, we got old school, we got new school, we got it all. And it's going to be amazing. It's going to be epic. Am I going to show them the two picks? Oh, I didn't see the last two picks you sent. Let's see, wait. Which two picks? I showed them the two Leia picks. What are the... Oh, those two picks. Wait, let me find them. Here we go. Let's go to Messenger, actually. Okay. So these are coming from Aries, okay? These are coming from Aries. Some specialty coils for you guys. All right, let's see here. We have this. That is, looks like alien. I don't know what that is. That's an alien framed staple, maybe? That is the actual, well, no, it's not the actual coil because he wouldn't have burnt it in, but an alien framed staple, it looks like. Correct me if I'm wrong, Aries, please, if that's not what that is. And also, it says it right there. It's a Fraplian, which looks like alien framed staple, probably. All right, and the other one is... a framed staple coil. Amazing looking. Look at that. It's so pretty. I'm assuming these are in stainless steel. And yes, these will be up for auction. Okay. Now, guys, don't you dare lowball them. I'm just saying, don't you dare lowball them. All right. These things take hours and hours to make and a lot of material. Okay. They are worth it. All right. They are worth 30, 40, 50 bucks. Yes, that is a lot to spend on a set of coils, but this set of coils will last you for like 6 months. Okay, way less than you would spend on stock coils that you're buying for your RDA that you have to change out every 2 weeks, okay? So absolutely, guys, these are specialty coils. They are designed for the advanced user, and they're amazing because they're made by Aries, and I'm so excited. All right, guys, I need to get out of here, but thank you all for hanging out tonight. I had a wonderful time. Make sure that you come back next week. Let's put the link in the room again, just to make sure that you know. Let's see, page. Do I still have it in my case? Yes, here we go. Make sure you go to that event on Facebook and say that you're interested, all right? All right, thank you so much, guys. I had a great time tonight. Probably we'll see you tomorrow from 4 to 6 right here on VU Live. It might be a little bit later than 4 to 6. Like I said, we're kind of doing that birthday / Father's Day thing tomorrow with the twins. So, if we are going to be late, though, we'll post it in the VU Live Facebook group. And we'll see you tomorrow. Bye!